Hi guys, welcome to the part 7 of the tutorial for beginners in AutoCAD. This time I will explain you about the command array and also some extra commands of the section modify, lengthen, break and align. Let's start. How to use the command array. If we go with the mouse and click in this arrow, we have here three options. And now we are going to select this one that says rectangular array. With this, we can copy the objects that we select and dispose them in a grid, like this example here. So, I'm going to click in the icon. Then I select the objects of this window. Press Enter. And now you can see this ribbon here that just appeared. Here we can control the number of items and the spacement between them. In this blank, we insert the horizontal spacement between the objects. At this moment is 2700, which is the distance between the first and second objects. I'm going to change it to 5000. I press Enter or click in another blank and you can see the difference now. Then I'm going to insert a vertical spacement, which for my case is 2600. As you see, now I have these windows disposed between the three floors and these four houses, which are exactly the number of columns and rows that you can see there. So, let's select the array again. If you notice, we only need to click in one object and you can see the blue icons appearing here. I'm going to explain you how they work. If I click in the first one, which is represented by a square, I can move our array to a different position. For example, I will move them vertically 1000 meters. If I click in the triangles located in the second column and the second row, I can change its spacement. For example, I will click here to change the vertical spacement. If I would click in that one, I would do the same, but for the horizontal distance. The triangles located in the last column and in the last row, what they do is to change the number of items. If I click here and I drag to the right, I can see that I'm increasing the number of columns. So, as you see, it was quite easy to use. In this part, I will show you the polar array. If I click in the arrow next to the command, I can select here polar array. Now I'm going to choose these two lines, press Enter, and for the center point of the array, I select the center of the circle. And as you see, the lines were disposed in a polar way and around this circle. Then, if we go to the ribbon, it's a bit different than the rectangular array. And in the first column, I can see also the number of items that I can switch. This is the angle between the next group of objects and the rest you will see. I will click here and change the number of items to 24. But suppose if I change the spacement for example, 10, the number of items remained the same, but obviously it didn't fill all the circle. And this number of 230, it's exactly this angle. Now, let's look to this part of the ribbon. Here, where it says rows, it is set as 1, because I only have items displayed around the circle line. If I change it to 5, I will have 5 rows of items displayed over each other. And the distance between them, I can change it here. For example, currently this distance is 266. By the way, this total here would be the distance from the first item to the last one. The last column, it's for the axis Z, so in 3D. I click and hold the mouse wheel and move the pointer around. I changed the view, and now even I have here 3 levels, the distance between each level is very small. That means I should change this distance to view anything. If I put 300, for example, you will see the difference. The last array type that I'm going to talk is path array. Imagine that we have a curve here and we want to place a certain object all along that curve. So this time we are going to click in path array, this icon. I'm going to select the object that I want to display all along the curve, press enter, and then I select the curve. As you see, I have now circles all along, but if I want them with a certain distance, I need to make some editings. So I will select the array path, and then I click in this triangle to change the distance of the objects. I will click, for example, here. I can also insert a specific distance here. But remember that this number is the distance along the path. For example, from here until there. It's always the distance along the path, and not the shortest one. Okay, I'm going to show you more modify commands that you can find under this section here. I will explain you just some of them that could be useful in any occasions. Command lengthen. As you may guess, this is used to modify the length of lines or line sections that are part of a polyline. I'm going to click in this arrow, and then the command is this one. Just click in it. If you look to the command bar, you can see several ways to modify the length of the line. At this moment, I will insert the total length, which is displayed here. So, I will click in this line, and I'm going to type the new total length. For example, 60. I press enter, and as you see, the new length is bigger than the current one, and if I click at the right, the line will extend to this side. Otherwise, if I want it to the left, I click in the other half part of the line. Okay, let's activate the command again, and this time I will type DE to choose the option delta. With this, I will type a value to add to the current length. If I type 20, now I go to this line and the line will increase 20 more, to the left or to the right, like before. To shorten the line, I could simply insert a negative value. And if I don't press enter right now, I could continue increasing it with the number that I inserted before. Another way is percent. Simply, I insert a percentage length. If I type 70, for example, the new length of the line will be 70% of its original one, so 30% less. Finally, I can use the option dynamic. I type dy, press enter, I click in the line that I want to change, and as you see, I can extend it by moving just my pointer. If I want until this vertical line, I can click here using the object snap point. Okay, now I'm going to tell you about the command break. There are two types, break and break at a point. First, I start with the command break. And with this, I will create a gap between two points in a line or a polyline. I click on it. Now I'm going to this rectangle. I click on it. And the place where I clicked was automatically considered the first point. And the thing is that this was without any precision. So if I type F, I can reinsert the first point. So I'm going to this place and I can click here outside the object and it will be projected to its closest point. Then I can click again for the second point. Here it is. Now we show you the icon break at a point. In this case, I select first the object. And then I only need to click in one point. For example, if I go here, I click, the polyline is split between this point and the origin, as you see here. Now I will show you the command align. It's this one. And with this, I can align an object with another one. I will show you. First, I select the object that I want to move, this one. I press enter and then I select the source point. It can be this one. And after the point where I want to move that object, this. After, I can select a second point. And imagine that I decided I want this point here. I click. And then, if I press enter, I will be asked if I want to scale the objects based on the alignment points. And this is because if I want to move these points to the places that I indicated, that rectangle has to be resized. So, if I say no, that I don't want, the object didn't change the size. And it was connected with the first point. Going back, if I would click yes, you can see that the object was scaled in order to connect both points. Now I show you the same, but the second point, I want to connect it to this other side of the square. So the line segment between the first and second points will be aligned between the first and second points of the second object. And if I click in no, to not scale, it makes a rotation like this. Therefore, if I click in yes to scale, this is the result. Okay, that's all in this part. Thank you very much for watching and continue to part 8. So, see you next.